So our first eight rounder, a middleweight for Felix Cash in the silver and blue, up against Francis Choffo of Lormont, France, in the camouflage and gold. And the first thing you notice about these two is the height difference between them. Choffo is in tremendous shape. I had a good close look at him yesterday, and he's got muscles on muscles. But when I asked him how tall he was, he gave me 5'6½". I'm not sure about that, Dave.
He's not 5'6½". He's my height. He's definitely short.
Choffo's record, 19 wins, 14 defeats. Never been stopped in those 14 defeats. He's been the distance with some good fighters. The most topical name being Maciej Selecki, who we saw give Daniel Jacobs such a good fight a few weeks ago. He used to be managed by John Pegg, so he's fought over in the UK quite a few times. Choffo has always gone the distance against the likes of Brian Rose, Chris Carslaw, Kelvin Young, Conor Law recently, as last year.
So he's been in the ring with some quality operators and been the distance with quality operators. So it'll be interesting to see how Felix Cash handles this.
Last time we saw Cash was on the Coley Chamberlain undercard back at the start of February. Stopped James Hagenimana in the fifth round. Got some good rounds under his belt there after a couple of quick wins. His career was hampered earlier on by a cut and some injuries, but he started to motor now. Nice left hand on the inside there from Choffo, just as Cash was starting to try and put his punches together.
Nice right hand from Cash there.
Matching fighters recently have been out on the west coast of the USA in Las Vegas and Oxnard, working at Freddie Roach's gym, Robert Garcia's gym, the likes of Cash and Cheeseman. Ricky Burns has been over there too, Joe Cordino, all of those boys. They get out and about as much as they can just to try and broaden their boxing education.
I think the good thing about this fight for Cash is that although he's going to have the awkwardness of the short, he's going to overcome. But if he teases with the jab, he keeps working the jab, Choffo's got to lunge in and he's got to reach in, which is going to leave gaps for smart counter shots. And that's what Cash has got to look at. Set things up with the jab, make him commit, make him fall short and pick the spots out.
Familiar scene at York Hall, the balcony absolutely packed, people just leaning over the edge of it. You get a great view up there, it's almost like you're floating over the top of the ring. And lots of people got here really, really early for the start of boxing tonight to make sure they got a good spot. And this is our opening TV fight, Felix Cash in the silver and blue, Francis Choffo in the camouflage with a bit of gold and red in there as well. Timeout called by Jeff Hines. And I think that belt line is too high for his liking now, maybe. He's just going to tug those shorts down a little bit. He did say when he brought them together at the centre of the ring at the start that that belt line was a bit too high. And not a bad trick to try and pull, because when you're the height he is, if you pull your belt line up, then all of a sudden there's no target at all to hit, really, to the body.
No, it's going to be hard to find that target as it is.
Right hand as he came forward there, Choffo. Caught Cash, and that's what he's going to have to deal with. He's got to get some snap on that jab and just stop his shorter, very compact, thick-set opponent just rushing him, because really that's kind of the only thing that he can do.
That's a nice shot.
Good left hand from Cash, really opened out and threw that one. Choffo was just knocked slightly off balance by it. Just got to keep that right glove up, Cash, because every now and again a big wide punch comes back from Choffo. It was just off the back of his own right hand. Cash almost got flipped by a left.
He has, but he started well. He's getting his jab going. He's not rushing things. He's picking the shots when they're there, and he's looking. He is looking to count when Choco's exposing himself by lunging in. That's a nice jab. He's mixing up. Sometimes it's a soft jab, just a little touch jab, and then he'll throw a stiff one in there. So he's not predictable with it. The problem that you can have is if Choco stops trying to throw and starts being aggressive, because with his size, he can climb up like a little turtle.
Just maintaining that gap here, Cash, which is a sensible thing to do. Not really allowing Choco a routine. Right hand effort. Cash is moving away to his right hand side. Again, looking to pop that jab. There's not an awful lot that Choco can do about this at the moment, but this is the kind of situation that he's well used to. Some of the superior heights and reach. He's got the guns to try and find a way inside it. Well, it's those two gentlemen who topped the bill. Two young undefeated cruiserweights once again headlined the matchroom show. Luke Watkins and Lawrence Okolie. This time we saw Okolie against Isaac Chamberlain, of course, back at the start of February.
See, we just saw that left hook that Cash landed there. That's what I'm talking about. He's catching him in the middle. If you saw Choco, he was just dropping that right hand ready to throw it. They're the seconds where Cash's counters are going to tell him that's the best chance he's got of knocking this guy out. Keep teasing him with that jab, make him think he can fire over the top of it.
Working well here. Choco's got the centre of the ring, but Cash just kind of moving around and using all the points of that compass, just keeping him turning, popping out the jab, throwing the right hand off the back of it. Nothing too elaborate, nothing too fancy, just good solid basics. The previous outings has won quite quickly. There's that left hand again there. Choco dropped that right, but I think he's come into this fight knowing that he's got a durable man in front of him and that he's going to have to, bit by bit, break him down.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's not a job you can go out there and be reckless with, because you can make fights like this very difficult. And it could become scrappy, it could become, close quarters, heads bumping, because you're in against a short guy. So he's doing all the right things, keeping it long, boxing smart. And look, that's nice, showing nice defence there when Choco's throwing. But a couple of moments, he has picked out the right times to attack with those counters. Left hook especially, but it is about being patient in fights like this. It can be very frustrating, because the fight itself, you can feel as though I'm not making a dent on him. He's doing the same thing over and over. He's still walking forward. I'm not catching him clean with enough shots. Is it entertaining enough? So these are the sort of things that fighters think when they're in there. But you have to be. That's a lovely right up and left hook. Lovely.
Look for the right to the body again there, and then through the left hand.
I like what he's doing. He's just being basic. He's sticking that jab, and then he's picking the right counters.
There's a snap on that jab. A bit more weight on that jab, I think, than I've noticed previously when I've seen Cash fight, and it's such a weapon to have. You've got a young fighter with a very solid jab, and it's a great foundation to try and work on.
Yeah, it gives you a head start. It's for me, it's the most vital weapon that a fighter can have, and it's locking. Titles have been won on jabs alone.
It's a foul. is the man I was referring to, and Cash actually found himself out behind Fowler when they were on the GB setup, and it was Fowler who made it to Rio 2016, and once that door was closed to Cash, that was really when he looked to try and make some inroads in the professional game, the turnover.
Getting beaten to the shot again. It can be frustrating for a young fighter that's wanting to impress in a fight like this, because not a lot of his punches are landing clean or not. He's not getting all his power shots off, but he's just got to make sure the right ones land at the right time.
Born in Cameroon, Francis Tiafoe, been a pro for over 10 years. That's that view from the balcony that I was talking about. It's a great place to watch boxing, Urkul, and it deserves the reputation that it has, because the atmosphere is always just so good here. I think when you have a night like tonight, and it's hot and sweaty and maybe a little bit uncomfortable at times, it all just kind of adds to it.
Yeah, it does. And the crowd that turned up here for all the shows, you know, they're knowledgeable, they love the boxing. A lot of the stadium fights, arena fights, you get people that just turn up for the event. But your call is where you get boxing fans turn up.
Chopper just trying to climb into a couple of left hands there, and he's still just throwing out that jab, Cash. Looking to lead with a left uppercut there, didn't land it. Nice right to the body as Chopper looked to try and come back with his own overhand right. Eventually finish that win in the fifth, so if he goes deeper into the fight here, then I think that will do him some good, get some rounds under the belt. Tiafoe can't do anything with him at all at the moment.
No, not at the moment, because that's because Cash is doing everything right. You know, he's boxing long, he's using his feet, he's making him reach all the time. You know, Tiafoe needs to set his feet in order to let go of his punches. He's just got to be concentrated and keep switched on.
Just changing direction there, Cash. Picking up his feet and then just darting away to the right-hand side. It's interesting watching his last fight actually against Aguilera. He was boxing really nicely on the outside, and then he took it up close, and we couldn't quite work out why he was doing it, but after the fight he said that he did it deliberately because he felt that that would be the way that he might find the openings, that he was landing from the outside but he couldn't really see an obvious route to a finish. And it just shows that sitting here watching it, you get a totally different view to what he's got in there.
Yeah, but it also shows the intelligence of the fighter, that he can adapt and he can switch mid-fight. You know, he's seen things up close, he's got his own perspective in it, and he's reading the fight himself. They're the kind of things that you need as you're stepping up the level.
Tony Sims, talking into the corner, he's got a fairly busy night tonight. Mark Seltzer as well.
They see a jab again. He's doing everything right. The jab's working really nicely. You know, Chopper, when he's wanting to set himself, and he drops his hands that little bit, Cash is alert to trying to find these little counters. And that's how the pattern of fight right from round one has been set. It's difficult to try and go and change that pattern, because then you're running the risk of making a more difficult fight. You know, obviously he's feeling his strength there, his game is tough. It's short, you don't want to be getting egg clashes, you don't want to get cuts and bruises when you don't need to.
Chopo's corner just putting the end swell on that left eye between rounds, so maybe that's just been bruised up a touch from that jab of Cash's, which is still just being banged out with some regularity. There's been a little bit more kind of finesse and precision about his footwork tonight too.
Yes, feet have been very good, and he's used them at the right time as well. I think as in the next round or so, I think what we might find Cash doing is start holding the centre ring and trying to maybe push Chopo back behind that jab. I'm not saying going to war with him and start taking him to a risk, but just trying a little bit more authority. As Chopo starts to tire a little bit and his energy levels drop, maybe then that jab can become a more aggressive jab that starts putting his back foot. Because I think once, if you can manage to put this guy on his back foot, then it's completely nullified the threat.
There's that left hand again, and it would be interesting, would be good to see him click through the gears in a really kind of controlled, precise fashion. Put that back hand in a little bit more, maybe go to the body there with the left hand and throw a few more combinations towards the end of this eight rounds, because it is looking likely that we will go deep into the fight. But there's no need for him to do anything different from what he's currently doing at the moment, Cash. He's controlling this comfortably and looking good doing it.
Beautiful right up there. You can see that Cash has got a lot of class. You know, the shots that he goes for and the punch-picking skills of him, you know, is very impressive. And again, it's all about being concentrated in this fight, because you can easily switch off, because you know it's one pace, it's controlling everything. It's easy to switch off and get careless. Nice little body shot he went for there. It's difficult landing body shots against somebody that's so much short as well, because you can feel exposed yourself. You're leaving your chin right in range for him to come across with a hook himself. So you have to time things really right.
Short, the overhand right to the floor back. Didn't manage to catch Cash. Nice right hand there, chopping down right hand, just caught Chopper on the side of the head as he tried to move it right to that. Felix Cash. It's the closing stages of the round. Nice crisp 1-2 as well. Felix Cash treating us to a good performance here against Francis Chopo. Just adding a little bit more flair towards the end of that previous round. Paul, the Upton fans making themselves heard as well. There's lots of them in here. They bring enormous support. Upton facing Ted Cheeseman later on for Cheeseman's WBA international title at Super Welterweight. Those two had a bit to say to each other on the scales yesterday. I said earlier on, every fighter has sold a good amount of tickets for this.
See, Cash is starting to put a little bit more authority on his jabs now. Still using his brain, still using his feet to get himself out of range.
Just spreading his gloves wide there as if to try and tempt Cash into a bit more of a close-up brawl, but he's not going to be fooled by that, because he's doing what he needs to do here. He's just not giving Chopo any kind of a look in at all.
Yeah, and Chopo doing that shows that he's starting to get a little bit frustrated now.
Tremendous condition, managing to soak those up.
I like might start dropping a few more right hands in now behind that jab. You start being a little bit more forceful. Lower it a little bit. A couple of times he's throwing the right hand, he's going over the top of his head. Just lower it a little bit. Aim for the top of his chest.
Yeah, if he goes a distance tonight, it will be the first time that he's completed the 8 rounds. It's a good box to tick. He's been after a big fight for a while. He really feels that he's ready to be tested. Taylor Jones is the Southern Area middleweight champion. He's got a defence scheduled for July the 14th. No opponent as yet, but last time I looked, Elliot Matthews, English champion. I don't think there's anything on the horizon for him just yet. Actually, he's just been paired by the board with Tyler Denny, but the date and venue of that one to be confirmed. Then further up the tree, you've got Liam Cameron, Commonwealth champion. And Jason Wellborn, now the British champion, after a tremendous fight against Tommy Langford. And you'd imagine that Cameron Woods and Wellborn's a pretty obvious fight to make. I think they both want to. He's got a way to go before he's at that kind of level yet, Cash. Although, he'll be starting to think about it before too long, I would dare say, if he can get the
solid
area.
Very good right hand.
Great right hand there from Cash. Just drops Chopo, puts him down. Oh. And the bell came. Had a very, very good time there for Francis Chopo. He got back to his feet, which was all he needed to do, and now takes a seat in the corner. But we were just saying, David, it would be good to see him just put a little bit of mustard on some of these shots and really build through the phases, if you like. He did it.
Lovely right hand there.
And this is what you want to see. Look at the way they went down as well. He's gone down pretty heavy there. Right at the point of the jaw.
Well, he's in terrific condition, Francis Chopo, so he managed to regain his feet. The bell had already gone. So that was...
If the bell hadn't gone, it would have been in serious trouble. Let's see if he's recovered.
Second round, seven.
So into the seventh round, Felix Cash is prowling in that blue corner. Keen to get back to work. And how's that minute between rounds been enough to steady Chopo after the trip to the canvas he took at the end of the sixth?
Legs are still unsteady.
Cash really looking to put it on him here. Right hand didn't quite land clean, but he's standing well in range here, Cash.
Here's his opportunity, because now Chopo's going to be swinging big time with those counters, a little bit too high. Maybe he can roll under and stick a little shot downstairs as well on his way.
Right to the body, followed by the left hand.
Now he's got him on back foot. Oh, shot.
Chopo just winging with the left hand. There was a touch open, but he took that 1-2 just prior to that, Chopo, and he took it well because it was solidly delivered. But there's a very open look to him now.
I'd like to see Cash just turn up the tempo a little bit, be a little bit more busy with the jab, a little bit heavy with the jab. When Chopo throws, make him miss it and go straight back to work on him.
Previous 20 seconds and maybe just taken a little bit of a breather. Still lying Chopo with suspicion here.
Step on him now, as he's backing up there, step on him.
For the uppercut with the right hand followed by the left, and neither one quite landed where he wanted them to.
Feels like he's just paused a little bit too much this round.
Look at him, he's holding up for dear life.
Time out called by Jeff Hines. He was having a quick word with Chopper about holding.
Be smart, keep your pressure, keep your shape and put the pressure on him.
Heavy looking left hand, and his gum shield, Chopper's gum shield, comes flying out onto the commentary table right at the end of that round, retrieved by Andrew Scott. Another good round for Cash, but as you say, Dave, and maybe you'll do it for us in this eighth and final round. The only thing that is missing here is him to really just work into the combinations and really put volumes of punches together.
Yeah, I think he's boxed out really fantastic all the way through. He's done a job what he needs to do. I just feel on dropping him, he knows hurt. That round, I feel as though he closed a little bit too much and he allowed him to gather himself. Even when he's backing him up, he wasn't putting enough output in his own punches.
Chopo, as I've been saying from the start, is a tough man. He's never been stopped in his 14 defeats. He's been a distance with the likes of Maciej Selecki, who went 12 and won the round against Daniel Jacobs. And he's been in with plenty of other good fighters too. So if Cash could somehow close the show here in the final round, he would be the first person to do it. But he scored the knockdown and he's bossed this from start to finish. He's not really been caught with anything. So there's really not very much to criticise at all. And this, with a completed eight rounds, would be, you would say, the ideal springboard to then try and go on to challenge for something. Jeff Hines has given him one very, very final warning here. We'll need to take a point here, Jeff. It wouldn't make any difference to anything whatsoever, but he will do it if he needs to, because he's got to apply the letter of the law.
For me, that shows that Chopper is struggling now. He's tired.
Chopper just swinging himself off balance. And referee seeing that there's no knockdown, wiping the gloves off.
Cash has been impressive tonight. It's very hard to look good against somebody like this. You know, sometimes, like I said, just because you've got a high advantage, sometimes it's very awkward to get your power shots off. Yes, you can control somebody with a jab, but it's awkward to get your power shots off and to look good. And I think he's looked good. He's done the right things at the right times. You know, he's picked some nice counters when Chopper was opening up. His timed it really, really well. The jabs have been very good. His feet have been fantastic. A good performance tonight.
That left hand again from Cash. And when you see two fighters of this kind of stature, the obvious thing to say is that the taller fighter needs to keep it on the outside and use the jab, but you've got to have proper snap on that jab to keep someone like him off. Otherwise, if he gets inside, he can make things very difficult.
100%, 100%. If there's nothing on your jab, they're just going to walk straight through you, and it's a grueling night for you. And like I said, something that's that high, up close, bumping heads on your nose and on your eyebrow, it's not good for your career. But he's controlled him fantastically. The left hand's been brilliant all night. He's changed it. It's not been a heavy jab every time. It's been a light jab, teasing him in, and then it's been a heavy jab to sting him and stop him in his tracks. The little feints, the little dips, it showed him something, and it has made Chopper second guess himself.
Would you say he's ready to step up and look at kind of English level or thereabouts?
English title level, definitely. Nothing yet, nothing above that yet, but English title level, definitely. And I feel, looking at him tonight, I feel that he's one of these kids that when he's in with somebody that's throwing punches, he's gonna be a very good counter puncher.
Still using that jab. And he's done the eight rounds nice and comfortably here. When you're boxing at your own pace, when you're controlling the pace like he is, then that always makes that a more straightforward task, but straightforward it never is. Eight rounds under the lights and a pretty hot York Hall. And there's a sleep for the crowd from Felix Cash. Good performance. Goes eight rounds for the first time. And appreciated by this large crowd, this sold out crowd who was sold out weeks ago. Good exposure Felix Cash. Well, here's the story of the fight. Just had answers for everything, really, for every kind of problem that Chopo was looking to try and pose for him, but it all just flowed off that jab, which is the traditionally what should happen.
Yeah, the jab set absolutely everything up. But when he had to, he put a little bit of spite, and as the fight went along, he started commanding that centre of ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to referee Jeff Hines' score totals. 80 points to 71. The winner, still undefeated, Felix Cash.
So, broad smile on the face there of Felix Cash. 80 points to 71, which was what it was always going to be. He's won every round and then had the knockdown in there as well.